probably heard of the men's shed movement around the country. They're designed to bring groups of blokes together and strengthen communities. And Jono Coleman warmed up his vocal cords to join a very special men's shed group.
Just limbering up, of course. Hello, Jonathan Coleman here. You know, we hear of men's sheds, of course. It's where men go and bond and have fellowship with fellow men, with a bit of woodworking and metalworking and fixing things. And, well, today we're visiting a men's shed with a difference. Come and join us. So here we are inside the rehearsal for the Men's Shed Chorale. They range in age from 60, 70, 80, 90. They sing beautifully. And today I'm going to see if they let me have a bit of a sing with them. So come and have a look. This is a men's shed with a difference. Peter McFarlane here is 94, just a boy.
Just a boy.
Do you enjoy being in the chorale?
Yeah, some of the blokes are a bit off, but yeah, most of the time. Yeah. Most of the time, yeah.
So what does it do for you when you're singing with the whole bunch?
It makes you feel really good, more alive than you were before you left home.
You're dying to get here if you practice. It wouldn't matter if we didn't do concerts, we'd still be here and we'd still love it.
Like well, the reason I come here is to get away from me missus.
Right.
I'm the conductor of the chorale,
yeah.
So I run all the rehearsals and the concerts and program all the music for the concerts as well.
Fantastic. And is it hard working with a slightly mature age group of people?
I'd say there are different challenges that you have, but the best thing about them is that they're all enthusiastic. They all want to be there.
Because there is a kind of kinship in a choir, isn't it?
You're absolutely. All... It's as much a social thing as a musical thing. These guys have been friends for so many, many years, and this is their time to meet and to catch up. We always go across the road for lunch afterwards. There's a great tradition of Welsh hymns with male choirs, so we do quite a lot of Welsh hymns. We do a couple of pop songs, so we do some Beatles songs. It's a real unifying thing for people of all ages, and it's one of the things that makes their choir and their friendship so strong is that what they get to do is make music.
We just do it because you like doing it, and the mates get you with.
Yeah.
And when you go into some of those old people's homes, some of them are pretty miserable, they're just sitting there.
Yep.
But when you start singing that, they look, and we had a mob about a couple of 6 months ago, half of them started crying when we started singing Danny Boy.
Oh.
They're all crying there, and I was nearly crying myself, but I had to keep singing. I love singing. I've sang all my life.
Physically, it's a really good exercise. It keeps us alive for many years. It's really good. Some people had emphysema and all that and kept them going.
When people sat around a fire singing of a Saturday night instead of watching the giggle box.
The giggle box.
Yeah.
So, Ray, how old are you?
90.
Why do you do it?
Because of these fellas. All these fellas here have been my companion for nearly 17 years.
And is it like your second family, I guess, your musical family?
Yeah, sorry to say, yeah.
I'm going to have a go at maybe singing a couple of songs as well.
Yeah, but give us a solo.
Oh, I don't know if I could do a solo. I do a bit of doe a deer, a female deer, Ray a drop of golden sun.
You might be able to join us.
Oh, yeah. I'm a bit young at the moment, but I'm working up to it, so.
Well, why is such a lovely day?
In between all the songs, they're talking about medical issues and what drugs they're on and how many times they get up and go to the toilet at night. Do you guys ever get nervous?
Not really, I think, because we've all sung for many years.
Right. Anybody could do this sort of thing.
Well, some people can't sing, but yeah. Neither can some of these blokes.
That's right.
They move the mouth as if they're singing.
That's right. That's what I was doing.
What a beautiful story from Jono Coleman, and a huge thank you to the Men's Shed Chorale. If you want to find out where they're performing next, head to mensshedchorale.com. Beautiful story, Jono.